And welcome back to the program. It's the Vicki McKenna Show. We have a left-wing organization funded by a left-wing PAC trying to sue out of existence school choice in Wisconsin. That's all school choice, by the way. Not just voucher-based school choice, but non-instrumentality charter schools, meaning non-union charter schools. All of it would go because a guy at the Minocqua Brewing Company is just a good check-the-box left-winger and decided he was going to fund a lawsuit. Now, one wonders whether he'll be able to continue to fund that after having to pay out $750,000 in a liable settlement, but we'll see. What does it mean if they're successful? It means... well, a whole bunch of things, but notably, it probably means some employers might have to go elsewhere in Wisconsin for employees, because we're already at a point where employers say most of the kids coming out of school don't even have basic skills. Scott Manley is standing by with Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce. That's why WMC filed an amicus to ask the Wisconsin Supreme Court to reject this case. Welcome to the show, Scott.
Thanks for having me, Vicki. Yeah, I mean, we all know the sort of the brutal truth of the matter, and this is based on DPI's own data, is that we've got about 2 out of 3 kids who can't read at grade level, and we've got about 2 out of 3 kids who can't do math at grade level. And so we have a bunch of kids who are graduating from our public school system that are not equipped the way we need them to be to enter the workforce and be productive workers. So we have been supporting school choice for many, many years because school choice actually outperforms the choice schools and independent charter schools actually outperform their public school counterparts. And we view choice and charter as just an absolutely critical piece in terms of how we can do a better job of educating kids for careers.
Well, we got to do something. I'm going to just go through, and I know there are more data points here in this survey, which was released over the summer, that was conducted of employers by Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, or on behalf of you. 3/4 of employers say that young people graduating from K-12 schools in Wisconsin are not prepared for the workforce. 41% say they provide remedial education and tutoring just so that their workforce can, you know, have basic skills. So remedial education and tutoring on basic skills, 41% of employers are doing that. 40% have lowered standards. And I forget the data point where many of Wisconsin's companies have gone from a written manual for employees to one with pictures, because the reading comprehension levels are so bad. That's what we're talking about here. These are not jobs that require college degrees. And we're having a very difficult time getting potential employees so that they're not going to hurt themselves or the company.
Yeah, we've got over half of businesses say that they've got employees who struggle to read and do basic math. And that's why 9 out of 10 employers strongly support school choice and charter schools. But the reality, Vicki, is that the employer community isn't alone in their support for choice and charter. We just had a survey done last month that found better than 2/3, 67% of likely voters support school choice and charter schools. And in fact, when you break that down by party, by an 18-point margin, Democrats support the school choice program. By a 37-point margin, independents support it. And by an 82-point margin, Republicans support it. So it doesn't matter if you're a Republican, a Democrat, or an independent. There is strong support in this state for school choice and charter school options for parents.
Yeah, and the thing is that what they're counting on is the politics to protect them. In the state of Illinois, knows that Democrats aren't going to be thrown out of power. They just killed off school choice in the state of Illinois. And they know they're not going to suffer politically too much for what they did. I think that's what they're reckoning here, especially if it comes from the court. Because what's going on here is it's not like, you know, Minocqua Brewing and its PAC are trying to work their way through a system. You know, by all indications, the lawyers who have looked at this case say it's a hot mess of a case to sort of hone it down so that it actually makes sense by the time it might get to the Wisconsin Supreme Court. They want the court to take it up directly and kill off this program. This would happen, Scott, in advance of the 2024 election. And these numbers you're talking about here would not bode well, right, for the Democrats in 2024. That's how determined they are to get rid of this program once and for all. They don't actually care if it hurts the politics.
Yeah, and we asked a question. You know, if you had to vote for a Supreme Court candidate who had voted to overturn the school choice law by huge margins, better than 2.5 to 1, they said no. I wouldn't support a justice who voted to overturn the school choice law. And then the next question we asked was, well, what about a legislator? Would you vote for a legislator who voted to overturn the school choice law? And it was 60% said, no, I would oppose a lawmaker who voted to end the choice program. And again, we're talking about bipartisan opposition to overturning this law. Voters don't care if it's the legislature that overturns it or if it would be the court that overturns it. They don't want, on a bipartisan basis, they don't want this law overturned. And I think, although I don't know, but I think the Democrats might have figured that out because Tony Evers filed a brief with the Supreme Court last week and said, don't take this case. This Minocqua Brewing guy who's funding this, don't take that case. And you know, I don't see, Tony Evers has never been a proponent of school choice or charter schools. If you look at his record
of his
as
own,
super,
yeah. Yeah, he's his own proponent. He's a proponent of left-wing politics, but he's not a proponent of stupidity. So I want to ask about the employers here. 3/4 of employers say that kids coming out of K-12 schools in Wisconsin are just simply not ready to hit the ground running. They need something. They need remediation. They need tutoring. They don't have the skills. How are we then matching up people in Wisconsin with the thousands and thousands and thousands of open jobs that are in Wisconsin, which still haven't been filled? What do you do if you're that company and you can't find a way to, you know, match up supposedly an educated young adult with a position of employment?
Yeah, it's just so hard, Vicki. I mean, we know from the data from the U.S. Department of Labor that we have about 2 job openings available for every worker who is unemployed. So we don't have enough workers as it is. Then when you add on top of that the workers who have entered the workforce who don't have the skills that are necessary because, as you just mentioned, they're struggling to read, they can't do math, and you know, actually being able to do math in a lot of professions, including in manufacturing and construction, is really important because a lot of times that involves adding or multiplying or dividing fractions. And if you can't do that, you can't do the job. Same thing, whether we're talking about construction or manufacturing, we have to maintain safe workplaces. If you can't read the safety manual to keep yourself and your coworkers safe, that's a bad outcome for everybody. And so we're really struggling right now, and we have to find ways to improve. And what the data tells us is that independent charter schools and choice schools are a big, big, big part of the solution.
Well, and they're not subject to the lectures of lunatics like Bettina Love and Ibram X. Kendi and these other, you know, people that are getting paid $400,000 to, quote, train teachers in Wisconsin who openly say, Nobody cares if they can do math because math is colonialism. Math is racist. Nobody cares, you know, if they're not reading whole books, because that's the Western view of things. That's colonization. I mean, that's the way DPI views education, that the problems these employers are identifying are not problems that are considered, you know, something to be worried about by DPI. That's a really serious concern. If we don't actually get aggressive in doing something about the failure of education, never mind protecting, you know, the one escape hatch in the form of charter schools or school choice. I mean, if I'm those employers, I'm either looking to import foreign labor or I'm looking to pack up and move out of Wisconsin.
Well, and we hope it doesn't come to that. But I do know this, Vicki, that increasingly there are parents who are saying, I want my kids to go to a school where they've got their eye on the ball. And having their eye on the ball means we're teaching the basics. We're teaching the fundamentals. We're teaching kids the skills that they need to be successful. That includes reading. It includes math. It includes science. What it doesn't include is sort of these boutique political agendas, because parents are sick of it. And we've seen polling that reinforces that they think we need to get back to basics. I mean, I saw a statistic a couple weeks ago, Vicki. I think it was a shockingly large percentage. It was more than half of kids who are in their 20s today didn't know about the Holocaust that happened in the 1940s. And I just, to me, that was breathtaking. Like, how could you?
What
go
are you waiting
through
your time on? Yeah. What are you teaching instead?
Right. Where are the priorities?
Well, the priorities are not to teach kids to read at grade level. The priorities are not to teach kids to do math at grade level. The priorities are not to connect children once they're young adults with, you know, gainful employment. None of this seems to be, you know, maybe we should start by drafting an overhaul of the mission statement of education here in Wisconsin. But it is bananas that the one escape hatch we do have is under attack by the left. That is how little they value actual education in our state. Scott, thanks for joining me on the show today.
Thanks for having me, Vicki.